nobody has more emotion and passion in their game calls than Paul Allen. Here's how it sounded last night.
Here's Jason Myers, and boom. Come on, miss hit it. It's a squib. Hey, let's see what happens. C.J. Ham picks it up at the 15. Let's go Cal Stanford. 25-30, C.J. Dropped the ball. Cool. Right on. And I think Seattle recovered it. Oh, what a perfect ending to a freaking miserable night in the Cappuccino Capital. Yeah, Seattle ball. That's the game. Good Lord.
Oh, cool. He dropped it. Paul Allen's the best. I've always said this. I consider him one of the best local radio hosts in America. He hosts Middays on KFAN in the Twin Cities. I think he's absolutely hysterical. I think his play-by-play is next-level good for the NFL on radio. And I just think the world of PA. He also does horse racing. He is so good at so many things. Bogish, I think you need to now use this in your repertoire. Openly root and get upset and make fun of the team if they make a mistake or they lose.
I can't. I refuse.
Why?
I can't. And I love Paul as much as you. I worked with him at Sirius a really long time ago. One of the best guys ever. I don't think you can be like that.
What do you mean?
You can't do that. You can't be angry at C.J. Ham for fumbling and ruining your night.
C.J.? I dropped the ball. Cool.
I know you're the voice of the Vikings.
Cool.
But
right
you're
on.
About to get back on the team plane and get a team meal and fly all the way back to Minnesota with the Vikings. You can't be mad at C.J. Ham like
he
that.
He don't care.
I know he doesn't.
He doesn't
and
care.
I wish I didn't care like he didn't care, but you can't do that.
Well, here's why he doesn't care. He knows he's been around longer and will be around even longer than C.J. Ham.
No, I know. And Mike Zimmer and Kirk Cousins and every other Viking fan is doing the same exact thing.
Paul Allen's been the voice of the Vikings since, like, what, the mid-90s, I think? So,
but everything he just did in that call goes against every single thing I was ever taught at Fordham by some of the legends of broadcasting.
Well, you know, it's never too old
to
learn.
You think Marty Glickman ever got mad at Frank Gifford for messing up a Giants game in 1950?
It's never too old to learn new tricks.
You think Vin Scully ever cursed at Sandy Koufax?
I've learned this many times. You're playing to your audience.
Yeah, Bob Papa's getting angry on Giant broadcast. That, I will give you that.
That is how Vikings fans felt. Listening to that. He's speaking to the Vikings fan. Am I right, Mraz?
I think you're spot on. And he's also showing he could be funny while being angry when he calls it the Cappuccino Capital of the World. Like, that's a good line to let you know it's okay to laugh, guys.
And I love sarcasm. Like, good, great, he dropped it. Like, it's a great line.
Cool is the best
but
line.
But I'd prefer if he was the color guy doing that and somebody was giving you more of a straight broadcast at the actual play-by-play.
Can we play this one more time? This final call is so good from Paul Allen last night, voice of the Vikings.
Here's Jason Myers, and boom. Come on, miss hit it. It's a squib. Hey, let's see what happens. C.J. Ham picks it up at the 15. Let's go Cal Stanford. 25-30, C.J. Dropped the ball. Cool. Right on. And I think Seattle recovered it. Oh, what a perfect ending to a freaking miserable night in the Cappuccino Capital.
He's so optimistic at the beginning.
Seattle ball. That's the game.
Good Lord. Excited about what might happen, and then C.J. Ham ruins it.
The crash of emotions from Paul Allen.
Let's do Cal Stanford.
Cool. Let's squib this. Let's get the ball back. All right. Really cool. Short kick. Cal Stanford. Here we go. Most historic play of all time. Here we go. Oh, cool. He dropped it. Awesome.
C.J. dropped the ball. Cool. Right on.
Great.
And awesome. Caps it all for the good Lord.
Sucks. That's a terrible, miserable night. Good Lord.
Good Lord.
He goes from so hopeful to just miserable.
He's
good.
Praying for Jason Myers' foot to fall off as he approaches that kick. And then he's screwing C.J. Ham. My goodness.
Oh, what a perfect ending to a freaking miserable night in the Cappuccino Capital.
The bottom line is, you get Paul Allen up 17-10 at halftime in Seattle on Monday Night Football, you better win.
Oh, man.
Close that out.
Good Lord. Oh, Paul Allen's the best. He is the absolute best.